Today we are going to discuss the questions of the chapter, the last week. So be ready to answer the questions. It will be a discussion and all of you will be taking part in it. So the first question is, what is Jhansi's illness? What can cure her, and the medicine or the willingness to live? So first, what is her illness? What has happened to her? Dipali, roll number 8, raise hand. Give the answer. All of you, please be ready, okay? Don't waste time in unmuting and then starting. Dipali.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Jhansi's illness was pneumonia. She would lie in her bed without moving, just gazing out of the window. Medicine and her willingness to live can cure her, because if she is willing to live, only then medicines would work upon her health and she would be cured.
Okay, that's okay. But what is her illness? The expression that her illness is pneumonia would not be correct. Okay, write this line in a proper way. What's her illness? Jhansi is suffering from pneumonia. Okay, she has caught pneumonia. Okay, she got pneumonia. Which season it was? It was the autumn season, and she got pneumonia. She was like constantly, she was always on bed. She had become a bit bedridden and was always looking out of the window, doing nothing, had almost lost her appetite and even desire to live. Appetite is a feeling for hunger. When you feel like eating something, it means that you have a good appetite. When you don't feel like eating anything or drinking anything, it means that you've lost your appetite. So her illness was that she had got pneumonia, and she was always on her bed and would keep on gazing at the window or looking at somewhere outside, out of the window. She had lost all interest in living, or eating or drinking anything. Her only desire, she always kept on waiting for her death, as she thought, like, if the last leaf on that ivy creeper would fall, then she would also die. Yes, as far as her cure is concerned, her disease was quite curable. Pneumonia was quite curable. The doctor told her friend Sue that if she would have the willingness to live, then the medicine will work instantly, and that actually happened. The day she realized that yes, she would not die, the same day the medicine worked and she started doing better. Okay, so it was her will to live which mattered more than even the medicine. But yes, the equal dose of medicine and willingness to live would cure her at the earliest. Is that right? So now the second question is, do you think the feeling of depression Jhansi has is common amongst teenagers? Before you answer this question, before you give answer on behalf of Jhansi, first tell me, like, do you think the teenagers develop a feeling of depression usually? If yes, like, in what context you say so? How can you say that teenagers develop a feeling of depression? What makes them become depressed? Yes, raise hand. I don't want answer on behalf of Jhansi. I want you to answer me, about teenagers. A general answer I want. Yes, Anshya.
Yes, the feeling of depression is common among teenagers nowadays. One reason for this can be competition and not scoring well in the examinations. The expectation of parents and peer pressures are some of the factors which have led to the problem of depression among teenagers.
Okay, yes. So Anshya said, like, peer pressure, pressure from parents, and then even competitions. So when there is a lot of competition, then even the those who are doing very good, even they sometimes become depressed because they are not able to come up to the expectations of their parents or teachers or sometimes of their friends also. Okay. Yes, this Japji, unmute yourself.
Yes, teenagers are. Yes, depression is very common among teenagers because they may undergo undergo this due to various reasons like stress, peer pressure, conflicts with parents, and academic pressure.
Okay. So conflict with parents, okay. Okay, then this Garima.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yes, because the children begin to gather the negative thoughts and have a fear of failures.
Okay. Now, Janvi or Gia?
Due to the last grades and lack of emotional maturity among the teenagers.
Okay, so Janvi and Gia say because of the emotional maturity among the teenagers, they become depressed very easily. Okay. Okay, Navneet, yes, unmute yourself. Yes, Navneet, beta, hurry up. You can unmute yourself. Yes.
Yes, the problem of depression is common among the youngsters as they feel like if they will not be able to succeed in some anything or like in studies, so they have to listen many things from their friends and from their families, and they will get depressed due to these reasons.
Okay, it's okay, but children, tell me one thing, is depression amongst teenagers only because of academics? Is it always about studies only or something else also? What are the other reasons which make children depressed? Not always. Yes, Gaurav? Gaurav, yes, unmute yourself. Gaurav, what happened? Gaurav is unable to unmute himself.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes.
Ma'am, in this case, teenagers are not able to control their emotions. So they are also feel depressed sometimes.
So you say like nowadays children are not able to express themselves. How can you say this?
And emotion control, emotion controlling is not...
No, you are saying emotion, they are not able to express themselves. Then you are saying emotional control. Should they control their emotions or should they express themselves? These are two different things. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
No, yes, ma'am. You're not making your point clear. What do you want to say? Like, why are teenagers, you know, very prone to depression nowadays? Yes. Anyone? Okay, this Jia Janvi again.
The family problems and absence of healthy lifestyle also leads to negativity and prone to depression.
Family problems and what?
Absence of health.
Health, I guess you are saying. When children are not healthy. Okay. Keep yourself unmuted and clear your point first. Don't be in a hurry to mute yourself at the earliest. Yes, Anshya?
Ma'am, the biggest reason for depression is the expectations of the people around the teenagers. Teenagers try to live up to those expectations, and when they can't do that, they just get depressed.
Okay, so inability to come up to the expectations, or you can say the same thing which you told earlier, peer pressure or the pressure from parent side. Parents are very ambitious. Okay, they want their children to be the best, to be at 100%, even 99% is not acceptable to the parents, same is with the school, same is with the authorities. So everywhere it is, so the children, those who are not able to come up to those expectations, which are very, very high, children, they tend to become depressed. Okay, so somebody was saying, Janvi and Gia, they were saying that, just a minute. Yes, Janvi and Gia, they were saying that, yes, because of the family problems, the children become depressed. Yeah, maybe. Okay, so in nutshell, children, let's conclude this point. Like, how teenagers are very prone to depression. The first and foremost reason is, of course, the peer pressure. Peer pressure or the pressure from parents. Parents, they are unduly ambitious about children's performance. If the child is already doing very good, the children want them to do even better. So it's okay. And secondly, the children tend to become depressed because of peer pressure. And moreover, it's just not about academics. It's about social status. It's about emotional EQ, which we call as emotional quotient. So they are not able to express themselves because they are in the families. They are not able to talk to anyone about their emotions. So when they are not able to express themselves in the family with their parents or with their siblings or with their very good friends, then they tend to become depressed because they are not able to find an outlet of their emotions. Teenagers need to talk to. Okay, because when children become adolescents, they develop so many emotional, physical or social changes in themselves, and they need to talk to others about those problems. And when they are not able to find a suitable person to talk to, when they don't get proper guidance, when they don't get proper support, then they tend to become emotionally disturbed, and that eventually results in depression. So it is because of, so teenagers, that it's not just about academics, it's also about their about the emotional support they need when they are adolescents, right? So they are not able to get a proper person, I mean some mature person who would be able to listen to them and guide them accordingly. So in the absence of a mature person or a right person, in the absence of emotional security, they become depressed. Okay, peer pressure, okay, parental pressure, okay, lack of emotional support system makes the teenagers become depressed. And at the most of all, nowadays, if you talk about the present day teenagers, they are more prone to depression because of the kind of social status they acquire by the time they become teenagers. Earlier children, that children used to live a very simple life. Parents used to be, parents didn't used to have many, sources to bring up their children. So the children used to have limited sources to live on. But nowadays, by the time the children become adolescents, they have already, got access to almost all the resources. For example, phone, you can say, the iPhone and all those things, the children who were brought up about 5 or 10 years ago, they never ever imagined a phone in their hand before their, 12th class or 11th class. But now a child, even, first standard child has a phone or has his personal phone, whatever the reason. Okay, it's not that I'm blaming the children or I'm blaming the parents. Whatever the reason is, but when children tend to have more of the facilities for them, when they would have something already with them, they would of course want more. And when there is no end to their desires, because all desires cannot be fulfilled in a limited time. So when their desires are unfulfilled, they become depressed. Of course, peer pressure again here. when your friend will have an iPhone and you have an Android, then of course some child might feel that I am not as rich as my friend is. Then these kinds of things tend to make children become depressed. So it is, you can say, it's not just about academics, it's also about social status, which children feel they should have, that makes them depressed. So it is like when there is no end to the desires, when we want unlimited. And moreover, if the children are more are prone to depression, that is also because of over undue attention given to the children. Nowadays, earlier the children used to be rough and tough. The parents used to make their children rough and tough. The upbringing was such. The children used to undergo a lot of struggle earlier. But nowadays, the children are provided all comforts, all luxuries, all facilities, all the resources, even when they are doing nothing. Okay, earlier, children used to be given a treat of an ice cream. They were used to be told, like, you'll get an ice cream, you'll get a chocolate when you will do this. They would be given a big task to get a chocolate. But nowadays, you can imagine what I mean. Like nowadays, the children are given the things in abundance. They don't need, they are not satisfied with something small as an award. So one reward also would mean not less than a bike or less than an iPhone nowadays. So something, you know, we people, okay, the society has become more materialistic. Instead of making children struggle to get something, now we have made children assess the things easily. So that is the main reason that nowadays children are not easily satisfied with whatever they are given in hand. Okay, nowadays the children are pampered, flattered, given all the luxuries, given all the comforts. Before they speak up, ask for something, the things are provided to them in bulk. Earlier, children used to be given two pens, and when their pens would finish, the parents would ask them to go for refill and all. But nowadays, these refilling and all have, you know, become extinct. These kinds of practices have gone off. The point is not that we have got more money. The point is that we have become very fond of comfort zone. Even the parents don't want to cross that comfort zone. That's why they are providing their children with whatever they can. The point is not like what they can. The point is like what they should. Okay, point is not that parents, whatever parents have, they always say like, it's all for our children. It's okay, whatever the parents have, that is for their children. But children should also have the habit to struggle to get even a chocolate. Okay, let them prepare for their whole test. Let them do their best for the work. Then let them have a chocolate. But if we are giving them a full, you know, big box of chocolates without doing anything, then why will there be a value of chocolate for him? He will value a diamond. He'll value an iPhone then. So point is let children struggle. Children are not struggling. Children are not doing anything. By the time the children become adolescents, they already have everything with them. So they don't learn what struggle is. They don't know what hard work is. They don't know what spanking is, what slapping is. And when the parents, you know, become strict with them one day for doing something wrong, then children tend to become depressed. So the reason of depression among teenagers is not academics, is not any problem, is not basically the peer pressure. It is because the children are provided a comfort zone right from their early childhood. The children are not given the practice of hard work or of struggle. They don't have to, you know, yearn for something. Let them want something. Let them work for something. Let them work hard for a chocolate. But no, the parents don't do this. The parents always feel that I want my child to have all comforts. Let him only study. The point is the child doesn't even study then. Okay, let the child work to get something. Point is, let the child go to the kitchen and get his plate done. It's not that he should be given a ready-made plate in hand and he just finishes and keeps it aside. and mothers or the parents, you know, or this or the house domestics help, they always come up and pick up the things, and children, you know, they feel like as if we are the kings of the world. And when these kings are deprived of something minor, they become depressed. Okay, so the parents need to give a healthy dose of strictness. I mean healthy dose. Okay, you can be strict, at the same time you can be friendly also, at the same time you can be strict, you can be friendly, at the same time you can tell your children. I'm telling parents, they can tell their children what do they expect from the children, what kind of behavior they expect from the children, right? So even when this online system was there, when the education system, when school was doing everything, okay, whatever you could have learned in the school, you are all learning the same thing at home also. But why this online system did not work that well? Because the parents did not get the work done from children. The parents did not wake up their children in time. The parents did not make their children get ready for the class. Okay, if the child is sleeping in the bed, the child could turn on the phone or the laptop or whatever, and they could attend the class thereby sleeping. If the teacher was not at home, the parents were there. Okay, the parents were there. They could have been very, particular about the classes of the children. So what is, why, and when in the end the children could not do anything in the exams, then the parents would come to school and would ask the school to go for online examination. Why would somebody ask for online examination when you can go to the markets, you can go to all restaurants, you can go to all places altogether, but you cannot come to school for exams, where the school is taking all precautions against crowd or sanitization and everything. The point is parental, it's not just one parent, it's like many parents. Yes, there are parents, there are some children, those who have always been up to date with their work. Okay, they have always been up to date with their work. It's just not work, I'm again saying. It's just not about academics. It's also about you know, habits, about manners, about etiquettes, about the social system. Okay, parents talk about like nowadays children have become spoiled because of phone and all. Yes, they have become spoiled because we could not check our children side by side. Why couldn't we check our children side by side? Because we thought like the child is now independent, let the child be what he is doing. We never came out of our comfort zone to talk to our children about what they are doing. Okay, so children, providing children with all the comforts, not giving them the time to struggle, not giving them the time to work, not giving them the time to prove themselves, that actually makes children more prone to depression in the end, believe me. So the question was very simple, but it needs a big thought, right? So whatever the problem is there at home, whatever, everybody can come out of it, provided the child has the values of hard work. The child knows how to come out of the stress, how to manage stress, how to manage anger, how to manage work, how to manage with the limited resources. Okay, these things are to be taught to the children, maybe by the school, maybe by the parents. It's all our, you know, collective responsibility. So that would be wrong to say that the teenagers are more prone to depression because of academics or parental pressure. If parents are expecting their children to score 100%, they know that their child can score 100%, mind it. Okay, this expectation is not wrong, mind it. It's not that every parent wants their child to score 100%. Parents know this, that their children can score 100%. Only then they say this. Okay, if the child is scoring 95% effortlessly, it means the child can score 100% also with a little bit of more work. try to understand my point, children. I say, you people told me in the very beginning, many of you, that ma'am, academic parents, you know, expect a lot from their children. Parents expect what they think their children can do. If a child is not, if a child is a little mentally very weak, if a child is not even able to read and write properly, that parent, the parent of that child will never ask that child to score 100%. They will say, okay, beta, you will, you can score this much. But you cannot take away the, you know, the, you cannot take away hard work from a child's life. Okay, the children, parents become strict with children when the time is over. The point is not about becoming strict. The point is about becoming particular about certain things. That's it. Give your children the values right from the childhood, the ones which you want them to inculcate. Okay, so the thing is, children tend to become depressed. Children are more prone to depression. One child spoke up like because they are emotionally weak, right? Why are the children emotionally weak? Because the parents did not make them emotionally strong right from childhood. Let the child become independent. Let the child work hard. Let the child struggle to get something. Don't, you know, pinpoint others for what the child is doing wrong. Okay, if the child is committing some mistake, try to find out why the child is doing something wrong. There might be something wrong with the child or the system. Okay, we cannot make the whole world, we cannot blame the world for when something goes wrong. We'll have to find the reason on our own, in our own system. And yes, children, you also remember that when parents expect you to do something, they expect that because they know that you can do that. Okay, parental pressure is pressure when they never ever saw you, when they don't know you. Okay, if a child is always securing 98% or 100% or 97%, if that child comes to 95%, it's not that the child's ability has become less. The child might have got some problem. Yes, he might have got some physical problem. The child might have not been able to understand some concept. But so far the child is able to, point out what was wrong, what went wrong with him. When the child is able to give a logical reason for it, it's okay. But if no, if the child has no logical reason to point out his fall, then it means that there was something wrong with the child. Is that clear? So then the child should not go to depression, because then parents need to take care of the child's emotional well-being also. The child should be talked to. And at the same time, the child must also believe that his parents are the best caretakers of him. No one can do more than more for you than what your parents are doing. No one is your better well-wisher than your parents. So becoming depressed is a symptom of weakness. It's a symptom of emotional weakness, physical weakness, or poor moral values. When there are no values among you, only then depression comes up. So becoming depressed is being weak. Mind it. So don't talk about becoming depressed. Talk about how to overcome sadness. Try to overcome what went wrong. Talk about your problems with your parents. Okay? And if or somebody at home, the one who can listen to you, maybe your grandparents. Okay, maybe your own brother or sister, elder brother or elder sister. If no one at home, then you can talk about your problems to your teachers. Okay, but don't make a, don't like tell your problems to each and everybody in the world. But yes, you may have somebody who you think can listen to you and can help you out. But yes, introspect your problem also. Introspect what wrong you are doing also. That is also there. Right? So we'll discuss the second question tomorrow. Okay, second question, because this was the general thing which needed to be talked about, because nowadays many children talk about like depression ho gaya mujhe. So depression is nothing but just an emotional weakness. And the reason for this emotional weakness, I've told you, like when children are not made to struggle more, when children have not been taught how to struggle, when children have not been taught how to work hard, when children have not been taught how to manage stress, when children have not been taught how to manage more work, then depression comes. Okay. When children have not been taught how to overcome challenges, then depression comes. If you, okay, whatever the problem, the point is like become emotionally strong, talk about your problems to others, maybe your anyone at home, and or if no one at home, then you can talk about your problems to your teachers. And many a times the teachers help you out with your problems. They sort out the things with your parents also. The point is, do talk about the things to somebody who is very, very mature. Okay, your friends cannot help you out because your friends are as silly as you people are. Okay, so your classmates cannot help you out in your personal problems because they are as silly, as stupid as you are. Okay, your friends have not done the PhD in sorting out your problems. Okay, so yes, there are some children, those who are very wise. You all know that. There are children, those who are very stable. There are children, those who have never ever fallen back. It's not about academics also. It's also about their emotional, you know, stability. So it's not that if I'm saying your friends are as silly as you, I don't mean serious. I'm just joking. The point is that they are of your age mates. They cannot be that mature as your parents are, or as your elder brother or elder sister maybe. But that person should be a right person whom you talk. Okay, we'll be continuing with the same chapter tomorrow, second question. So be prepared with the answers. Thank you, Shalini. I guess the time is also over. Thank you.